Where do you believe the Congress, the Samajwadi Party alliance, where has the story gone wrong for this alliance?
Three or four points. First of all, I would still hold my horses till about 10:30 or 11. But yes, I concede that if this trend persists even partially, this is not only a victory, it's a remarkable victory. Second point, I think we have to all accept that 90% of all of us, that includes you, your channels, other channels, discussants and Delhi, got it wrong on November 9 onwards. Till now.
So,
number three, I don't believe that it validates demonetization. A wrong decision will remain wrong on economic policy, on economic principle and theory.
Sir,
but
on a day when the BJP, on
Mr.
a day
Modi
when the
has
BJP
sold the narrative very, very effectively.
You all keep
saying, very, very effectively.
I'm saying all Congress leaders are saying
no,
Modi
Mr.
has sold
Modi,
the narrative
don't
effectively.
Say BJP,
you're saying.
Mr.
Okay, just hold on. Shivraj Singh Chauhan, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister, is also speaking. Abhishek ji, let me just go to him.
आसान भी लेकिन कुल मिला के मोदी जी देश की जनता के दिलों पे राज कर
So everyone, the full credit for this victory for the BJP goes to Modi, and you yourself are saying this, Abhishek ji, weren't you? That the credit for this goes to Prime Minister Modi. Much like I would say that in Punjab, the credit for Punjab victory doesn't go to Rahul Gandhi, it goes to Amrinder Singh.
Look, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, over 10 years, in two national elections and about 15 assembly elections, has tasted victory. He has been more than generous in sharing that victory. He has tasted big defeats from 2014, and he has been more than brave in taking the bullet on his own chest and chin and coming up and owning it up.
Sir.
So he believes in sharing of victory and owning up of defeat single-handedly.
Well, I'd like
so
to see. I'd like to see when Rahul Gandhi accepts responsibility.
Goes like that.
I'd like to see. I'd like to see when Rahul Gandhi does that. Uttarakhand, you've lost. Uttarakhand is lost.
He does it at the end of every defeat.
Really?
He takes
three
the credit, the debit on himself, and he shares the credit. I think you are factually
wrong. Really?
I've seen it again and again.
Sopan, you know, I mean, the famous story of the Congress Party always has been that when there is a victory, certainly the high command is to be credited. When there is a loss, it's the local leadership, you know, which gets blamed.
Well, I recall in the election of 2007 in Uttar Pradesh, when the Congress underperformed compared to their expectations, Salman Khurshid said that we didn't live up to the expectations. We let Rahul Gandhi down.
That's
so I think that is the psychology.
10 years ago, after we were defeated twice in Delhi, Rahul Gandhi was the first
and
to
I
come
think,
on the stage.
You know, the apparatchiks of the Congress Party, who basically convinced themselves that demonetization is going to lead to a huge popular revulsion against the BJP, they don't want to admit that they miscalculated.
You know, Patrick, I'm looking at
I was one of the apparatchiks.
Yeah, yes. sure.
I completely agree with Chopin that I totally miscalculated the political impact, but I maintain that what I've said about the economic impact is true and will be proven.
Can
to
I
be
just
true.
Take a quick
but
news
as far
update?
As Rahul Gandhi is concerned,
yeah.
Please don't be so unfair.
So how
he
unfair,
has been.
Sir? I think, sir, Rahul Gandhi will go
in.
I insist on this.
Sure.
That when we lost the Lok Sabha election in 2014, Rahul Gandhi went on television the same day and took the debit for it.
Sir, why
when
is Rahul Gandhi still the leader
Delhi,
of the Congress Party?
We
I want to know,
it.
Sir.
So no,
sir,
did,
I don't get this.
Old story.
Sir, I don't get this.
No, no,
forever
he's right.
A leader
Money
in
is right. He did take
for,
it.
Forever, he's, can, forever
you,
he's a leader in waiting.
Are you factually denying that Rahul Gandhi went on TV screens and said that
and then,
I take the responsibility?
So what happens then? When you take the responsibility, you take the responsibility for a loss, I agree.
Well, that's what
then
I'm
what
saying.
Do you do? Then what do you do?
Then you try and...
Then you keep on remaining
you,
in your leadership
you try,
isolation. You go on a holiday.
Then you try and recover. And holidays are sometimes a way of bouncing back. was true of Rahul Gandhi that he did bounce back after his long vipassana.
Mani, you know, now there's another interesting result which is coming in. Iram Sharmila, who floated her own People's Resurgence and Justice Alliance party, after ending many, many years of fast, look at what's happened. So the closest example, and maybe it's a comparison of apples and oranges, but the closest example that comes to my mind was Yogendra Yadav when he decided to contest elections Well, he ended up losing his deposit. I don't know whether Iram Sharmila has also lost a deposit.
No, I think that's not a fair comparison. It would be more like Meera Patkar.
With Meera Patkar, okay, fair enough. And Meera Patkar also lost the election. Now, Iram Sharmila has lost to the sitting Chief Minister, Ibobi Singh. And just looking at those numbers, it appears that maybe the one state where the Congress could still be in business, other than, of course, Punjab, where they have won,
Goa
they seem to be doing rather well. The BJP down, but in the big state, the story is the big state of Uttar Pradesh. The big state of Uttar Pradesh clearly has gone with Prime Minister Modi. Pankuri Pathak, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, joining us. Pankuri ji, welcome. Bad day for you, Pankuri ji. Now, in hindsight, tell me, this war which erupted within the Samajwadi Party over these last 3 to 4 months, is that what has got the better of the Samajwadi Party alliance?
No, Bhupendra, I think it has nothing to do with the rift in the family or with Mr. Rahul Gandhi or Mayawati ji. I think it is the polarization that worked, and it worked really well.
I'm amazed, Pankuri ji, spokesperson. Is this a narrative which has been fixed up? Blame polarization. Why are you unwilling to accept responsibility that maybe your chief minister, maybe Akhilesh Yadav, could not lead his troops? Maybe the entire drama which unfolded, maybe that is what has impacted your performance.
Bhupendra, we had a very positive campaign and we are proud of it. And we, you know, people are saying that the polarization happened in the last phases, but let us not forget how in the beginning also a lot of BJP leaders were talking about Kerala and Kashmir. So somehow it got the better of it, and demonetization did not, you know, it did not continue to remain that big.
What was the narrative which you put out?
This is what has happened.
What was the narrative that Akhilesh Yadav put out? Akhilesh Yadav said Kaam Bolta Hai. His Kaam Bolta Hai was based on a private road which was built from Lucknow to Agra. Is that Kaam Bolta Hai? I mean, if this is look at the larger trend, ma'am.
No,
BJP today is making dents in your strongholds. If I was to create an entire social pyramid for you, the truth is that those communities, Kurmis, Koeris, which used to be with the Samajwadi Party, assiduously built by Mulayam Singh Yadav, today may have moved away from you. That should be a cause of concern for you, I say.
See, Bhupendra, I'll tell you that this calculation of the BJP of not putting forward a CM face also worked in their favor, because every caste and subcaste was kept hoping that they'll get a CM from their own community. So I think the real challenge for the BJP would begin now, because a lot of people would be let down.
What about your challenge? Are you worried, Pankuri ji, that this leadership battle which was settled... Is Akhilesh Yadav going to remain the leader? Will he remain the leader of the Samajwadi Party?
Yes, for sure.
You really telling me with this kind of a performance, you think Shivpal Yadav and Mulayam Singh Yadav will not come back to snipe at the heels of Akhilesh Yadav?
See, I think we'll have to introspect and we'll have to, somehow fix the accountability for the loss. But then Akhilesh ji has been accepted as the leader by the entire party. So I don't think we have any second thoughts. And probably we'll, look into what went wrong with our campaign,
Ajay,
and how we could not raise the right issues.
No, Ajay, so now you're saying we couldn't raise... So there's polarization, you couldn't raise the right issues, and you're unwilling to accept the fact that maybe... You know, and I distinctly remember Modi when he was campaigning across Purvanchal. He said, don't vote for a Trishanku Vidhan Sabha. Do you believe that when he was adhering to the Trishanku Vidhan Sabha example, was he trying to say that if you vote for the Samajwadi Party, it's an unstable party, it's an unstable alliance? Wasted. Was Samajwadi Party coming across as an unstable party this election?
Listen, Bhupen, it was a difficult election from the Samajwadi Party from the first go. Because, after all, it was going to face anti-incumbency. So there's no question that this anti-incumbency, which Akhilesh, I must say, to his credit, did this tremendous media communication job
just
in trying
Keshav
to get
Maurya
out of
speaking,
that.
Ajay. Keshav Maurya is speaking.
Hey!
केशव जी क्या कहेंगे आज आप लगातार जीत की तरफ आगे बढ़ रहे हैं?
कि मैं जो पहले कह रहा था वही बात आज कह रहा हूं। मैं उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता के चरणों में सर रख करके भारतीय जनता पार्टी को इतनी बड़ी विजय दिलाने के लिए मैं बहुत वंदन करता हूं और अपने एक एक कार्यकर्ता को बहुत बधाई देता हूं जिन्होंने रात दिन परिश्रम करके भारतीय जनता पार्टी को विजय के द्वार पर लाने का काम किया है। 14 वर्ष का वनवास खत्म करने का काम किया है। उत्तर प्रदेश से कुशासन को मिटा करके सुशासन लाने का काम
किया।
यह विषय केंद्रीय संसदीय बोर्ड का है। परिणाम आने दीजिए। केंद्रीय संसदीय बोर्ड की बैठक के बाद, विधायक दल के निर्णय के बाद जो भी होगा उसकी भी जानकारी आपको देंगे।
क्या आप मुख्यमंत्री का पद स्वीकार करेंगे?
आज उसका परिणाम है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के कार्यकर्ताओं की मेहनत और आम मतदाताओं के द्वारा दिया गया आशीर्वाद भारतीय जनता पार्टी को उत्तर प्रदेश और उत्तराखंड में प्रचंड बहुमत दे रही है और हमें विश्वास है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रति जो रुझान अभी दिखाई दे रहे हैं यह प्रचंड बहुमत के साथ सरकार बनाने में भी एकदम फलीभूत होंगे।
महाराज जी, अब इन रुझानों के बाद में समाजवादी पार्टी अखिलेश यादव और राहुल गांधी के लिए आपका क्या संदेश रहेगा?
देखिए, इनका गठबंधन को जनता ने नकारा है। हाँ। और जनता ने इसको इसलिए भी नकारा है क्योंकि देश के हित में भी और प्रदेश के हित में भी ये लोग नहीं थे, इसलिए स्वाभाविक रूप से जनता एसपी कांग्रेस के गठबंधन को और बहुजन समाजवादी पार्टी को पूरी तरह खारिज कर चुकी है। उत्तर प्रदेश की जनता अब सपा बसपा या कांग्रेस के फर्जी नारों में नहीं आने वाली है। उन्हें वास्तव में विकास चाहिए, उन्हें सुरक्षा चाहिए, विकास नमा भेदभाव के चाहिए और सुरक्षा भी उन्हें बिना भेदभाव के चाहिए। मुझे लगता है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी जिन मुद्दों को लेकर के गई थी कि विकास सबका लेकिन तुष्टिकरण किसी का नहीं, तुष्टिकरण की राजनीति के दिन लद गए हैं और वास्तव में प्रदेश में सुशासन की स्थापना होगी।
मुख्यमंत्री की जिम्मेदारी
सौंपती है तो क्या? देखिए, सो यू आर हियरिंग फ्रॉम द पॉसिबल चीफ मिनिस्टर कैंडिडेट मनी, यू वांट टू से समथिंग?
द की वर्ड इज तुष्टिकरण।
तुष्टिकरण,
दैट इज इट इज वेरी मच पार्ट ऑफ द डायलॉग दैट हैज टेकन प्लेस देयर एंड देयरफॉर एवरी टाइम समबडी यूजेस द वर्ड polarization, don't leap on them.
No, like I'll tell you why. Don't leap on them
in the manner in which you are.
I'll tell you why.
There is polarization attempted. It has taken place.
I'm not denying that.
But it's not the only cause.
That's what I'm objecting.
But it's not the only cause. But you're denying that it is any cause.
I'm not saying it doesn't exist.
Let us accept it.
For the result, I say the result is not because of polarization. I say the result is not because of polarization. That's my point.
But polarization is one of the causes.
Polarization is undeniable. But Manishankar Iyer would rather believe that it stems from something called a false consciousness.
Mm.
It's not. What has happened is there is evidence that there has been a lack of even-handedness in the governance.
Mm.
And that has allowed this sort of feeling that one section of the community is being preferred over others.
So I'm
and
looking,
I think
I'm
that,
looking at the
that is if you want
I'm looking at the social pyramid of UP. I'm looking at the social pyramid of UP. So here is a party which is now up in 290 segments out of 403. It's a party which gives roughly 145 tickets to the economically backward classes in UP, but chooses not to give any representation, any ticket to Muslims. Now, Patrick French, the fact that this party now is in power in Uttar Pradesh, there is bound to be criticism. There's bound to be criticism that you are not representing the interests of minorities. How does the BJP, how does Prime Minister Modi now respond to that criticism?
Well, he has to decide whether to reach out or not. Now, there was a calculation taken in advance of the campaign, probably by Amit Shah in consultation with the Prime Minister, which was that despite the fact that UP has a population of around 40 million Muslims, which, as I pointed out on earlier show, is roughly equivalent to the entire population of Canada, not one of them was thought fit to be put forward as a BJP candidate.
Mm.
That's a major potential problem. Having said that, on this argument of polarization, I don't think that if you look at UP in the 1950s, the 80s, or the early 90s, that the kind of polarization that you've seen in the last couple of years is in any way comparable. Instead, what you've seen is a kind of polarization light, where you ring a little bell and you alert your supporters to the fact that it's always there in the background. But I don't think it's fair in any way to say that the BJP's victory can be seen as dependent on polarization. It is a minor factor.
That it may be a factor, but it's a minor factor.
Bhupen, just look at it from the other side. And I think this really helped the BJP. If you look at the BSP, the main thrust of its campaign this time was the Dalit Muslim Alliance. Mm. So basically looking at the Muslim minority as a key factor in the elections. Mm. The Samajwadi Party allied with the Congress for only one reason, to try and get the Muslim vote. Mm. So I, to some extent, if you look at the BJP's already, as Manish correctly pointed out, that's in its DNA, to polarize it on religious grounds. Mm. It helps the BJP because the other parties are actually helping the BJP convince other people that, listen, all these people are doing is trying to use the Muslim card, and therefore the Hindu card is more successful.
That's the whole argument.
So I think we need to accept
that. When you have a scenario where a BSP decides to give tickets to 100 Muslims and openly talks about giving representation to them and says that, you know, you vote for me on the basis of community, then the counter argument will be that if the BJP is choosing not to play up to that kind of a sentiment, well, is there any difference between the two? Let me go back to Sanket Upadhyay and just get a sense in terms of a comparison of what Mayawati was doing and what Narendra Modi were doing in terms of campaigning. How did that play out as far as the results are concerned in the state of UP?
You mean ROTI, return on time invested. Before I come to that, Bhupen, you have to look at this. Your discussion was largely talking about the factors, community factors. Mm-hmm. Let's quickly take a look at the Muslim and the Dalit factor right here. So these were the two constituencies, Mr. Ajoy. These were the two constituencies as far as the Bahujan Samaj Party is concerned. They were concentrating. The result on these constituencies, which have both of them combined, they are 249 strong, right? The BJP is leading on 173. The BSP, clearly, I mean, it's a no-brainer that it has not worked for the BSP. They're leading only on 14. SP and Congress have done better on these seats. They are at 58. Now, if I were to go one by one, basically the seats which have high Muslim domination, BJP has done well on those seats. We're not necessarily saying that the Muslims have voted for the BJP. We are saying that here the Muslim factor was high. So perhaps other constituents may have voted for the BJP. You have something.
I need to point out that if there was one party, not two parties, aspiring for the Muslim vote, the results may well have been different.
Yeah.
Because the Muslims constitute a fairly large proportion of civil society, you know, in Uttar Pradesh.
You know, before
but
I
what
let
has
you continue,
happened is that there are two parties
that's right.
doing this.
That's right.
And therefore the Muslim vote gets
Ajada,
divided.
Just one moment. You know, we have to remind our viewers at this moment that we basically claimed that we will call the elections first at 6 a.m. We've been saying that for the past 3 days. We actually did so. Take a look at this presentation that we have prepared on how all the elections were called fast and first only on CNN News 18.
Buzzer is ringing. BJP is winning the state of Uttarakhand. CNN News 18 is calling this election clearly at 9:20 a.m. 9:27, we have called the election for Uttar Pradesh. 9:44, and we're saying it clearly that the state of Punjab is set to be going to the Congress party. Well, that's why we say when it's election time, CNN News 18 and all the channels of Network 18 need to be your destination. You've seen how quickly we've been able to get you all the results because we've invested, we've spent a lot of time, energy in ensuring that across each voting booth, across each counting booth, counting station, there are representatives who are giving you real-time data, which is why we've been the fastest while the others have been way behind. Even the Election Commission of India, I'm getting messages from the Election Commission in India. How is it that that we managed to call these elections so quickly? Be that as it may, let me go to Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Abhishek, just to carry forward this discussion, of the trouble, the cup of woes for the Congress party, and this insistence on polarization being a factor. Let me flip that argument around. Does it not worry you that in key states, whether it's Madhya Pradesh, whether it's Bihar, now in Uttar Pradesh, the vote which used to be with the Congress party at one point of time, the backwards, the Dalits, the upper castes, slowly all these vote blocks are moving away from the Congress party. Does that worry you?
Well, obviously, major states in the heartland states have moved away because these groups have gone. But the worrying part is that these moved out to regional parties earlier. What is now worrying is that many of these blocks are going to the BJP in state-specific elections. So, yes, it is a matter of worry because the BJP has opportunistically but yet effectively, and UP is an example, it could not have happened, the results you are showing, without major caste blocks moving away this time from regional parties.
So why is that
away
happening?
To the BJP.
So why is Narendra
so
Modi positioning
cause for
himself
for the Congress earlier,
yes, so why,
the regional parties, and now for every other party?
Why is Narendra Modi managing to get this traction amongst the poor and the backwards? You know, you are leveled, Rahul Gandhi leveled this suit boot ki sarkar jibe against Narendra Modi. Now see how very cleverly the BJP has completely created a new social coalition around itself, and that could well be its social base now in the forthcoming years.
I think this requires deeper research. But let me tell you one small quick fact. It is really after Mr. Rahul Gandhi's suit boot ki sarkar, which seemed to have hit right in the gut, that a large number of policies of the Modi government have turned different. They have in the budgets, in the budget presented after that, and in the very many pronouncements by Mr. Modi, a more inclusive approach was shown only after that continuous attack on him by Mr. Rahul Gandhi. So I think a certain amount of truth of that attack has been validated.
No, I mean,
but having said that, the real point is that we need to win back. And to my mind, ultimately, we need to decide to kind of fight these structural states alone for one or even two elections.
Good point. Good point. That's a good headline. Are you saying? Are you saying? Are you saying? Are you saying, Abhishek?
We may not win.
Abhishek, are you saying?
To work out the structural.
Are you saying, Abhishek ji, that it was a mistake? It was a mistake for you to have joined hands with the Samajwadi Party, and you should have contested these elections on your own. If you're saying that you need to contest next one or two elections on your own.
Not at all. Not at all. No, no.
Then
there is a difference between the time factor then. And in the circumstances, it was the best decision. But when you ask me the longer term perspective, because this time we are now looking at structural issues, then I said this. At that time, it's very easy to be wise by hindsight. At that time, to prevent vote division, to prevent what we thought would benefit the BJP, it was the best decision. Everybody can be wise by hindsight. But I agree that for a longer term surgery, you require to be able to wait out in the recuperating room for longer. And this we are now talking of is longer-term surgery for structural issues like Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, and Uttar Pradesh in particular.
Well, you know, I remember when you use the word surgery, the interview that comes to my mind was given by the RSS chief Mohan Rao Bhagwat in 2009 after the BJP lost, who said that the BJP requires a complete surgery. And the BJP did undergo a surgery. Surgeries are always painful. But look at where the BJP is. It's literally resembling the Bharatiya Juggernaut Party. Amit Shah now, state after state, is ensuring that he's picking up the big states. Barring Bihar and the small state of Delhi, Amit Shah certainly has his finger on the pulse. And I think that needs to be stated very, very clearly. Yatish, the point which has been made there by Abhishek Singhvi.
Two points which came out very interesting from it. One is that, you know, while they're, he's still not admitting that they got the narrative wrong, the other part which is that how many people does Congress actually have on the ground who can activate booth level voters. They didn't have it. I mean, like, the fact of the matter is they don't have a ground level support. And you know, when you look at BJP, just don't look at Amit Shah.
Yeah, hold on, Maria Shakir, my colleague, is joining us from the BJP headquarters with Ravi Shankar Prasad. Always is there when there's a victory. Maria, Ravi Shankar Prasad celebrating Holi early today.
In fact, I'm at his residence, not at the BJP headquarters. He will be going to the BJP headquarters shortly. Ravi Shankar Prasad, who was campaigning also in UP and trying to really promote the Digital India campaign, right? Ensuring that the idea of brand Modi further gets communicated to people. Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, when you look at UP results, was it expected?
I remember meeting you in the campaign where you mentioned to me about the surge of BJP. I acknowledge that for you today. But it is a tsunami, mind you. And I had mentioned, you know, I have traveled all the length of the UP. This kind of result cannot be explained in simple terms. It is a vote for development. It is a vote for social inclusion. It is a profound statement by the people of Uttar Pradesh. For development, we are required to go. You just mentioned about Digital India. You know, we have got 50,000 digital kiosks, common service centers.
Right.
I held a meeting in Kashi, 5,000 came, including Muslims, deprived section of women. In Meerut, about 10,000 people came. This Anganwadi is the given digital literacy. All was creating a resonance, Ujjwala Yojana, which my good friend Dharmendra Pradhan was promoting in a very big way. This Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, as the postal minister, I was promoting that. I could see a different resonance. And apart from the larger Modiji's image, that you need to work together to ensure development. That has been the result.
Mr. Prasad, do you think that this is essentially, for all those who were saying that this is a midterm referendum on Prime Minister Modi and his policies at the center, your critics will be silenced now. They have much more to think. And for all those talking about the axis of opposition unity, that changes forever now.
I would say this, Maria, that all the political pundits, good luck to them, need to understand the tectonic shift which is happening in the polity of India. Today, Modi ji is the messiah of the poor, of the underprivileged. Ye hamara aadmi hai. Ye hamari baat karta hai. And that is a big change also in the character of BJP. Plus good governance, honest governance, good delivery, the image of India, a good kind of leader of courage. All this is working together. But above all, they were saying about hamare kaam bolte hain. I said karna mein bolte hain. But what is important is, I could see on the ground a very profound resonance. This woman dignity issue, the way they have been treated, all was working together. But again, 280 plus in a number of 400 plus is a rare phenomenon in the polity of India.
Okay, talking about the rare phenomena, because you're highlighting the numbers, sir. Do you think that there is much more to this? It's not just BJP getting its caste calculation right. Do you get this sense? Because when I was traveling UP, I had written that piece that this is almost like some kind of emergence of a new class for brand Narendra Modi.
I would put it differently. You parade empowerment of the backward caste. It gets reduced as a farce of the family empowerment. This they were realizing. You must understand that. The BJP built new coalitions